probably the biggest question we're getting here in the ESAB booth is all about the lift TIG start on the Rebel. And it's actually not as hard as you think. There's two options when it comes to setting it up. You simply go into the machine, go into your parameters for lift TIG, and you basically have two options. You have a two-step or a four-step. Now, one of the nice features is you also have upslope and downslope, but we'll get into that later. I have this machine set up for a four-step lift TIG start. That means there's four steps required to start the arc, weld, and then stop the arc. Works like this. To start with the four-step lift TIG, first step is we're going to turn on the gas right here at the torch. Then you'll touch the tungsten directly onto the material that you're going to weld. Then you're going to press and hold down the button on the torch, and then you are going to break the contact between the tungsten and the material. That's going to give you a small flashlight arc that you can use to get the torch into position. Then you'll release the button, the upslope will kick in and we'll ramp up to our amperage. We'll then begin to weld, and when you want to stop, you simply press the button again. The arc will then downslope to the parameters that you set in the machine, and then you can stop. Now, it's very different than a high frequency start that a lot of people are used to, where you just get the tungsten near where you're going to weld and hit the pedal and the arc jumps onto the workpiece. There are some times when you want to use lift TIG on a project. If I'm working in tubing and I have a very deep notch and maybe I'm running an excessive amount of stick out and I need to get the arc to start in a very specific spot, I'll simply set the machine up for touch start and lift TIG, stick the TIG tungsten right into the very belly of that notch, and then when I energize it with the button and pull it off, that's exactly where that arc will start. It won't wander around. Sometimes on high freq and a high moisture environment, the actual arc will start to jump off the tungsten a little bit differently. And you'll see that when we go over here and look at high freq. Follow me. Come on, bud. Let's go.